YouTube, how you doing, Earthlings? Here I am, it's just me. Bit of a different video, just wanted to show you these little fellas down here. Fellas and fella S's, maybe. Get your fingers out the way of my screen, and hopefully I can zoom in. Is this going to work? Yeah, I think I'm going to have to hold them here. Oh, just got a message. Right, I've been kind of making these little robots. They're all lit up eyes and things. Can you see that properly? Yeah. Zoom into it. Zoom into my hand, please. From box of junk plastic and my small bits of plastic. These are bits that I've got two interesting bits that I've been sort of sticking onto chocolate egg things and painting them up. You might, the people who are motor racing fans might recognise that colour scheme as being the Gulf Air colour scheme, and then just put in some greeblies on the back. Make sure I get them in shot. Lots of greeblies and stuff. Headphone bits. I have plenty of. I can't get these to zoom in properly, to focus properly. Come on. Focus camera. Yeah, I think that's about it. I mean, a lot of these bits move, get their aerials in them. Not really sure what scale they are yet, whether they're sort of that sort of person scale, or whether they're this sort of person scale, or somewhere in between, but I don't know yet. They were kind of looking a bit naff, but then I painted some of them up and gave them some armour bits, some guns and some glowy eyes. I don't know if you can see the glowy eyes there. There's some fluorescent yellow paint and bits of headphone bits and fans of the drones might recognise some of these feet because I've stolen some and put some all sorts of come on, zoom in properly. Yeah, I think that's it. Lots of bits and pieces. Well, they did look a bit naff, as I was saying, and then I painted some of them up. And, well, this is what they kind of looked like before I'm painting them up. Yeah, there's more drone feet there. Come on, zoom in properly. You know you want to. Do a bit of that, and then a bit of that. But, yeah, there's still a work in progress, some of them. And that's one of my MI, I think, robots. I rebuilt after it being in pieces, very much like a lot of my bits and pieces, robots and models and things. There's one that's sort of kind of got a naff colour scheme, but work in progress. And fans of a certain TV series, Tales from the Loop, might recognise this colour scheme as being Jacob the robot, although obviously doesn't look anything like Jacob. back there. Yeah, but I love that little robot. Jacob the robot from Tales from the Loop. And this one is the colour scheme of Scrapper. Scrapper the robot from the same series. You can see the bright eyes now, I think. And got to paint up those piston-y bits on the back there. But and the missiles need painting as well. The sort of cluster bomb missile type things. Can you see that? Is that zooming in? I don't know if they're zooming in properly. But yeah, well, mainly, just going to show you them sort of mucking about, really. There's another one there that I built and took apart because he didn't look very good. He had that sort of head thing that's sitting behind him, attached to him. And there's my drones, my work in progress. I kind of think I'm a little bit over my head making these things, but as you can see, I've done a lot of the replacing of the bits of plastic that broke off and then started attaching their legs. They're the cast parts that I cast in resin the other day, and just to show you these bits and pieces. These are the other bits that I made whilst with the excess. There's my stormtrooper guns. That one didn't come out that well, missing its barrel. There's a Han Solo blaster. There's that mini slave one. Honestly, it's not just a little blurry thing. There's that little minute Millennium Falcon. And there's the skull that I didn't know was a skull. It's actually quite a nice skull, actually. And the Stormtrooper head from the original figure line. And there's one of the Mandalorian pendants that I, can you see that? Is that zooming in? I don't know if any of this is zooming in properly. It might look quite good once you get it on a big screen. But yeah, I just wanted to talk about Tales from the Loop, really. That's the main part of this video, main reason for this video, I should say. I've been doing a lot of the detail to his face, and I think he's coming out. Quite a lot of how I wanted him to look. But yeah, Tales from the Loop. Here I am again. I'm actually in my second viewing of it at the moment because it's so good. It's a series that's what they call it, Retro Futurism Sci-Fi series, and it comes from the imagination of Simon Stålenhag, I think that's his name, a Swedish. Swedish guy who does all these art books. Let me just hold that there. Does all these art books from Simon Stålenhag here. Art books of sort of future, past futurism. What did I call it again? Retro futurism. Lots of different types of books. Different books he's done. He's done Tales from the Loop, Things from the Flood, Generation Zero, The Labyrinth, The Electric State. All very good, amazing, wonderful designs of his robots and his sort of sci-fi world from the sort of 80s period. And it was taken, I and I one of the TV series manufacturers, and I think it's, what's the guy's name, Martin Hepburn or something, Halpern, Matthew Halpern or something, I can't remember his name, but it's he's the one that wrote the actual stories for it after just taking the visuals from the books, and made it into this series, Tales from the Loop. The first season is 8 episodes long, and it has some amazing soundtrack as well by Philip Glass and someone else, a double-barreled surname guy. It's just absolutely magical, the TV series. It's sort of strangely beautiful and mesmerising. You don't really get to know what the hell the loop is, really. It's just my amp deciding that he doesn't want to be connected to my iPod anymore, because I have to turn my music off. I Wagner, and Creatures from the Cretaceous. His whole sort of premise from it all was when he was a kid. Simon Stålenhag was it, when he was a kid, and he had a book about how, you know, about just pictures of his area that he lived, but with loads of dinosaurs sort of in the background, and sort of dinosaurs were living about during the sort of 80s or 70s, 80s when he was growing up. So he's developed that into big robots and big spaceships and that sort of sitting about, and weird things that come out from floods, and amazing visionary artist. And I just absolutely love the series. I can't wait for the next series. Hopefully there'll be another one. But there's all sorts of old vehicles in it as well. It's just magical. And Jacob the robot, that isn't really giving too much away about the series, but his name's Jacob. You'll find out why in the series if you get to watch it. But, I'm going to show you a quick picture of Jacob the robot, actually. A quick still. You'll be able to see my rendition of the artwork that I did on that little robot, and I will be doing a few more little robots, I think, just sort of getting together old shampoo bottles and things, anything I can find really to have a shape. I'd like to do a version of Jacob the robot. Let me just show you it's on Prime Video, by the way, if you want to watch it. Jacob the robot, here he is. It's kind of a chicken walker type thing, but he's just, all these robots are just sort of about, no reason why they're there, they're just there. And also my little robots, they were kind of inspired by, I'll have to have another little look in my PC very quickly just to have a look, see what the Ashley Wood. Sorry, I've just got a PC keeps on deciding that I don't want pictures on my folders anymore and getting rid of them. Yeah, threeA Toys, Ashley Wood, and they're sort of robots he has in that series of action figures, 12-inch action figures. It comes from a series called World War Robot. See if you have a look up World War Robots and World War Robot, the series, and the action figures that go with them. They're very excellent, just the quality of the painting, they just look real. They're just amazing what can be done these days. Another one of someone who does amazing action figures is Snow Corporation. Dorgamore Snow, it's not his real name. His real name's Thomas, I think. But he does all these action figures of, and they just look real. They just look like, you know, the photography he does is just amazing. And just sells them for many hundreds of pounds each. Same as these Ashley Wood 3A toy action figure line, and they're just amazing what can be done these days. So I've taken a lot of my inspiration from that sort of dirty world of Simon Stålenhag and the sort of the bashed up robots of the World War robots and the Ashley Wood toys. Well, I can't really call them toys, they're sort of adult collectibles. But yeah, I just thought I'd share my thoughts on one of my favourite TV sci-fi programmes that's come about for many, many years. When was it released? Let me have a quick look. It was released in 2020, last year. Only one season of it so far. But yeah, it's well worth a look, well worth a watch, if you can get to watch it. And check out 3A Toys, Ashley Wood's Creations, and Dorgamore Snow Corporation on Facebook and Twitter and that, I think. Just doing a search on Google, you'll find lots of the action figures. In fact, I'm probably going to show you what I mean very quickly. I'll just go back into this folder again, this folder and that folder and this folder, and this is the Ashley Wood type thing that he does. You'll be able to see where I got the inspiration from. Just amazing paint jobs on them, and there's some of the people that are involved in the whole series of, but just the paint work on it is just incredible. I've still got to dirty mine up a little bit and do some rustiness on them. And very quickly go and have a quick look at the Snow Corporation, his stuff he does. There he is, Dorgamore Snow himself, and the bikes and some of the creations he's made. Just amazing work. Quite incredible what they do. Anyway, hope you like that little video. Please like and subscribe. If you did, please leave a like, because that does mean a lot to me. If you do, leave a like, maybe leave a comment if you're interested in this sort of stuff. And as I am, I can't afford any of the figures myself, unfortunately. One of my neighbours is a very great 3A Ashley Wood action figure collector. But some of the stuff these days, I'm just going to show you this quick picture actually, very quickly. In here, someone else has done these figures here, and they're just amazing work. Amazing. They just look real. It's very much a, I don't know who's done these, but they're just amazing. It's very much a sort of a what's his name? Chappie the film sort of look. But yeah. Anyway, like I said, hope you enjoyed the little video, and hope you enjoy watching Tales from the Tales from the Loop. And he said Tales from the Flood there, very similar. Because I think you'll enjoy it. It's a brilliant series, and the music is just amazing, and a whole lot of it is just magical series to watch. Anyway, take care and be safe in the coronavirus we're in at the moment. Take care, goodbye.